According to the FBI, North Korea's totalitarian dictatorship may have been involved in an act of cyber warfare against the United States by hacking into Sony Pictures Entertainment's computers in order to intimidate them into not releasing The Interview, a comedy movie starring James Franco and Seth Rogen. Unfortunately, the North Koreans have succeeded. Rather than defending freedom of expression, Sony caved into the pressure and has canceled the wide release of the film and downscaled it to mainly an internet release. Sony's decision to capitulate to the demands of cyber terrorists is an affront to those who have sacrificed in order to defend freedom and freedom of expression, and in particular, artistic freedom around the world. The North Korean regime survives because it brainwashes its citizens, depriving them of basic human rights that we take for granted. The dictatorship exerts complete control over the country using violence, concentration camps, and public executions to punish those who dare to disagree. And yet, despite all this, millions of brave North Koreans hunger for a better life, defy the regime in every day by secretly consuming films, TV shows, books, articles, and any other information from the outside world that they could get their hands on. Since 2009, an organization called the Human Rights Foundation has partnered with North Koreans who have risked their lives to escape the tyranny that has caused so much suffering. The Human Rights Foundation is using hydrogen balloons to airlift material, movie DVDs, and music CDs beyond the demilitarized zone to give North Koreans a taste of U.S. culture and freedom. One North Korean woman who watched a smuggled copy of the movie The Titanic had never seen an American movie before and didn't know that an American movie industry even existed. After viewing the movie, she was determined to escape North Korea to see a different world, one where freedom exists and where people actually are willing to lay down their lives for somebody else, as was the theme of the Titanic movie. This is in sharp contrast to the brainwashing in North Korean propaganda that shows only the state being their friends, and their allegiance is something to be given only to the state. After many struggles, she succeeded in defecting to the West, where she is enjoying a living and a lifestyle in which can only be considered another world, like a foreign world, not just another country, since the differences are so vast and overwhelming. If you are interested in helping support the efforts to get truth into the hands of North Koreans in the form of DVDs and CDs, computer programs, and even printed leaflets and information, all airdropped by small hydrogen balloons, you might visit www.hackthemback.com. Your support will allow vital information to get into the hands of the North Korean people so that they can begin to choose for themselves the kind of world in which they want to live in. There is no dungeon deep enough to hide the truth and no wall high enough to stop the message of freedom. Fortunately, tyranny cannot control the winds that allow the hydrogen balloons to deliver a taste of freedom to the information-starved people of North Korea.